Hello viewers, I don't come again. No, this one na Lady B Breaking News Channel. If this na your first time of watching my YouTube channel, oh yeah, hit that red button and also click on the notification bell so that anytime I post any tori, it will surely inform you. I want to say thank you to my subscribers and my viewers. Thanks for watching my video. And those who never subscribe, I know you can do better. Oh yeah, hit that red button. So my antenna carry another tori come today. This one about Biafra land. This our able Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. He talk am say, make we come together, whether far or wide. Make we come, make we make sure say Biafra come to stay. He also talk am say, everybody should be at alert. We should be at alert, make we dey gidigba, so that anything we come, we go surely fit defend ourselves. He also talk about this late Ikonso. He talk am say, this man, he dey defend our land. This man no do anything. He was just there to defend our country, defend our land. Now they just kill the man, go like that. He talk say, there will be no peace. So he say, but this man, he say, make the produce am alive. Now be the only thing where he be say, go make peace day this country. He talk say, the man, either they produce am alive or there will be war against Ebu Beagu. He talk am say, he go hunt down Ebu Beagu because they are not real. So now all waiting this man talk be that. So I post the video, make una listen, make una hear waiting in talk about our country, make you hear everything we talk about Biafra, so that you, we go know how to defend ourselves, and make we hear everything we talk. I know if he talk everything, but make una listen to the video. If una get any question to ask, or if una get anything to say, make una comment on the comment section so that people go know wetin dey una mind, wetin una get to tell other people, so that we go actually know wetin dey una mind. So make una no forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel, and also make una hit the notification bell so that anytime I post any tori, it will surely inform una. Oh yeah, make una watch the video.
I see things before they happen. And the prophecies we give is exact, 100% accurate, no room for ambiguity. And today I am telling you, Roba, if you fail to rise up, in our time, Fulani will swallow you the way they have swallowed Middle Belt. They will swallow you, and then you will come to us for help. And then we'll tell you, I told you so, you must move now. Strike the rod, the iron while it is hot. You must strike now. Destroy every police station, every army barracks. That is your problem. Because anytime you start a protest, army will come and kill you. Anytime you talk, they will arrest you. DSS. Destroy DSS. Destroy the army. Destroy the police. I'm telling you, you're free people. If you keep listening, to Tinubu, to Obasanjo, you people are finished. Look at the way Danjuma is now sounding. Danjuma is now saying, defend yourself. So the same person that killed you, Rosi, for the Fulani. You people, you never learn because you don't know history. You have no idea of what history is. Fulani would tell anyway, let me leave autumn to his problems. Let us even go to Zamfara. Let us try Zamfara State. What are they saying in Zamfara State? Defend yourselves. Zamfara State governor, Fulani man, is telling you, defend yourselves. And I'm asking them, if the Fulani is coming to my village, as they intend to do, they said they are coming. They are camping at a place behind Afra Technical School. Maybe very soon, Miyetiala intend to use them to launch an attack on my village, or perhaps in my house. I think we don't know all this, and we are waiting for them. That is the prelude I need. Just like the killing of Ikonso, I've been wanting to get the Igbo governors for a very long time. And then they killed Ikonso. That gave us the cover we needed to hunt them down. Do you understand? Let them launch the attack they want to launch. That will give us the impetus we need to sink, to bond you down before their eyes so they will see it. So the one they'll be calling America and Britain, nobody will listen to them. They will say, you know what Britain said to them? Britain said to Fulham, you cursed it. We told you to restructure and you said no. We have washed our hands clean. Britain for the first time said to Fulham, we asked you to restructure and you said no. Don't call us anymore. And I'm sure Britain 2 days ago told you the same thing. They don't listen. Because Fulani agenda is not to build a nation with you or to build a country with you. They want to conquer you. That is why any initiative, any policy, any steps that can be taken by a government to make the lives of the citizens better, Fulani have steadfastly refused to take such. Heaven will give him as I give to the living. That's my job, and that's what I'm going to do. Until Biafra is set free. Sam Fara governor is telling you, defend your Fulani governor. Defend yourselves. Whereas in our land, when I set up ESN to defend our land, governors went and set up something recruiting policemen from everywhere to defend them. Anybody asking you to go outside, if I say back outside, they'll be killed. I'm saying it, the time now is 8:44. Which is, should I say, 16 minutes to 9 a.m. in Biafra land. Anybody wearing that Igbo uniform, if you see you outside, will kill you. They're not even Igbo people. They're not even Biafran people. These are policemen recruited from every police station around the zoo to protect Umar. That uniform you're wearing that looks like the uniform of a warder that hasn't received salary for 4 months. That uniform you're wearing, if we catch you with it, we will kill you. Your eyes will open. In fact, the person will be waiting for you on the other side. Useless fools. That Ibubaku rubbish cannot work. If we see you, you are in Ibubaku, you are an informant, you will die. And we will treat you like a foreign Mietian Ajanjawit. If I see you with that uniform answering Ibubaku, you will die. I will kill you. And I will start to make police state. And I want Umahi to know. Go and tell Umahi what I'm saying. Anybody wearing Ibubaku uniform, I will kill you. Idiots. You want and recruited policeman. One, I think his name is it Dio? Or is it, I'll get to it in a minute. You don't know we are IPOB. Are you playing with us? Do you know how intelligent we are? You cannot do anything without us. No. You went and brought a Yoruba policeman to make him a Bubako in a Boy State to protect you. From today, I will hunt down the Bubako. Wherever I see you, you will die there where you are. That uniform you're putting on. Go and look at all those warders that are owing money, salary for 6 months. That's the way they look. That's the uniform they wear. You want to scare your enemies and you're dressing like a Nigerian prison warder. Tunde is his name. Thank you. Tunde is a Bubako in Lagos State. Tunde, shameless fools. I told you nobody will join you. If you join the Bubago, you have signed your death warrant. You will go and die around, stupid idiots. The December of autumn said, we are becoming a banana republic. If we have a president who gave the security agency's order to shoot at sight, whoever is having AK-47, and the Minister of Defense came out to say that they cannot shoot at sight. So who is the commander-in-chief of the armed forces? You're asking me, when I told you that Buhari is dead, did you believe me? Did I not tell you that Buhari is dead? How can Buhari give order to shoot aside anybody carrying AK-47? The Minister of Defense came out and said, no, they will not do it. Why? Because you're asking us to shoot our own fellow Fulani carrying AK-47. Intellectuals is for you. Intellectual, Igbo intellectual, this is for you. The Minister of Defense, a Fulani man, said, we cannot kill our fellow Fulani. Although they are terrorists, although they are bandits, although they are killing, raping, pillaging, and kidnapping, no, we cannot touch them. They are following. Take them to court. But you come and you kill the consul, and you want us to be happy. Who puts them is a dead man. He will die. We will die. Say, I said so this morning. I'm saying it loud and clear for the world to hear. So when it happens, you know who to arrest or who to blame. And then we hope them will die. These idiots, can you listen to Fulani man defending Fulani terrorists and killers? He goes out defending his father's land. You killed him. You killed him. We are going to show you madness. You see, maybe it's Akola. You know the one they call Akola. You know there are the faces of madness. You know if you're from the town wearing bongo and high heels in those days and you're mad, it's called Akola. The one in the village is called Onyara. We'll show you Akola. The one wearing bongo, fashionable madness, is called Akola. That's what I'm going to show you people. There are everywhere. Who puts on the man, a dead man walking, tell him I said, sure, I'll kill him. Okay, I'm saying it live on air for the world to hear. I can make Google post on the market, will be all gone. It's an idiot. You killed the consul, whereas a Fulani defense minister. Governor Otam is asking you, Fulani defense minister said you cannot kill Fulani people. Never you cannot kill them. It's now you know you're in a banana republic. Well, sir, before you didn't know you were in a banana republic before. Now you know. Now you know. He comes for defending his father's land against Miyet Yala terrorist group. You killed him in his sleep. You lied. Punch newspaper lied. Yoruba people, you people are acting as conduit for the lies of the flag. You lied like he was in a battlefield. You liars and deceivers, you lied whereas he was in his father's compound. If he goes was in battlefield, you think you can defeat him? Is that what you think? Not in a billion years. Weekend. Oh my God! In chicken, remember. All that little thing. Hey, block everywhere. Block every entry. You've not started blocking. You block and block the road to your bedroom. I will sacrifice anything to get Biafra. I said it before. Everything the world can be chicken, I will give to you. Anything he wants of me, I will give him. To make sure that Biafra comes. But all of you, all that money, all that money you stole and bank abroad for your children to enjoy, you will not enjoy it. And neither will your children. I will show you people insanity. Oh, Diara. Let us be going in the coming days and weeks. You will see madness. Go push at them. Come to Imo State. Come to Imo State now. Is it to send for an agent to fly helicopter? Oh, helicopter. You can fly helicopter on Unite. You're wasting your time. I will get you alive. Any traditional ruler, say I'm elder, and it's your four, we hold your four of the land. Any local government who puts on my goes to, I will destroy the local government headquarters. I will destroy the chairman, I will destroy the traditional ruler. Until you produce a concept for me alive. He comes from either you produce him alive, anywhere who puts on him, anywhere he goes to, any local government, anywhere you find him, he's gone. You people can be doing that, your rubbish with Miyet Yala, with Sultan of Sokoto, your boyfriends in the north, because most of the lecturers anyway, they aren't boys. You go there, you pull down your poster, she was looking, but you didn't have it. You come and you're writing rubbish, writing junk. You people will see madness now. In your next life, if you hear it goes, so you'll be running. You'll be running. And all these people, like they now go to synagogue to arrest people. I will no longer go for weekend. I will go for the commissioner of police and the DPO. Any commissioner of police, any DPO that goes into a synagogue again to arrest the children of God, I will come after you and your family. Wherever they are. Weke is a dead man. If Weke doesn't die, then I will know I'm not in the can. Okay, I'm ready. He must die. He can recruit all this nonsense he's recruiting. I want Weke, I will get you. I'm telling you the fact. I will get you. Drop on the awesome. Go and ask others. Have it is with them. I will get you. I will get you. You killed the consul, defending his land. Minister of Defense of Nigeria. He's saying you cannot kill those who are carrying AK-47, raping, killing, and pillaging. Contrary to the orders so-called given by who you call Buhari, does that not tell you that Buhari is no longer alive? The old idiotic, decaying Buhari.